Mr. Tarrou, in this video, we're going to do an example of a particle in motion and describing its position with a position vector, which makes this technically a calc 2 or calc BC concept. And if you're studying for the AP test here in 2020, you know that it is not going to be on this year's test, but it will be on future years, and maybe we're just looking at this for learning something in our calculus classes. And it sounds complicated in the fact that I'm talking about position vectors here, but really all this question is involving is our understanding of the net change theorem, that when you integrate velocity, you get a displacement or net change from your initial position. So let's go ahead and get going. We have a particle moves in the xy plane so that its velocity vector at time t is v of t is equal to, and depending on your textbook, you'll have this notation differently, like in IB, our vectors are going to be stacked probably in a vertical orientation where it would be t squared, and this is the sine of pi t, but we're using this this sort of arrow notation here, that vector v of t is equal to, or described by t squared for the movement in the horizontal direction along the x-axis, and sine of pi t for our vertical movement. And the particle's position at t equals 1 is described by the position vector of 2, 0. What's a position vector of the particle when t is equal to 5? Okay, so basically this really is a review of some concepts you learn in Calc AB or Calc 1, which is we're just going to be analyzing the position of a particle both horizontally and vertical separately. So it's really kind of just two separate problems of net change theorem, basically. So at time is equal to 1, the horizontal position is 2. So as far as horizontally, where is the position, where is the particle at t is equal to 5, that is going to be equal to 2 plus, now we're going to integrate the velocity function describing that horizontal movement. So because our initial position of this particle is described when t is equal to 1, we're going to then use that independent value of 1 as our lower limit, because that's going to be its position. Its position horizontally was 2 when t is equal to 1, and now we're going to then move or look at that velocity from time is equal to 1 to time is equal to 5. So we're looking at 2 plus the definite integral from 1 to 5 of t squared dt. So again, this is the horizontal location, and we have 2 plus 1/3 t cubed with an upper limit of 5 and 1. So that's going to be 2 plus 1/3 5 cubed minus 1/3 of 1 cubed. So that's going to be 2 plus 125 over 3 minus, now that's going to just be 1/3. So 2 plus 124 over 3, which is going to be 2 plus, what is that going to be, 41 1/3. Or 43 1/3. Okay, now, what is that vertical location going to be? So, because right now we have the first part of our vector, which is 43 1/3. Where is the vertical location? Well, our initial position is at 0. Go ahead and do this in a different color. Off of that, we're going to move again from that time period of 1 to 5. And this is our velocity function for the vertical velocity. And that means if we integrate a rate of change, if we integrate that velocity, we get a displacement or an amount of change from position off of 0. So as we integrate this, we have a function of pi t inside the sine function. We can do a u substitution, which of course is totally appropriate. Or we can just say, well, if u is equal to pi t, then u prime is going to be equal to pi. This plus zero is not really going to do anything here. And if we introduce a multiplication of pi in our integrand to finish the chain rule, then we need to balance that with the division of pi. So we have 1 over pi. And now we're just going to integrate. We have 1 over pi is going to get multiplied to our result of integrating here. And the integral of the sine of u, u prime, is equal to negative cosine of u, or pi t, with an upper limit of 5 and 1. So we just have to be careful with the negative, or we can just bring it out front and have negative 1 over pi times cosine of pi t with our 5 and 1. Moving that negative out front is going to make our work a little bit easier and, you know, minimize our chance of a sine error. Okay, so the cosine of 5 pi is equal to negative 1, and the cosine of pi is once again negative 1. No, so we just have negative 1 plus 1, which is 0. Our vertical location is 0, so our position function for our particle is going to be 43 and 1/3. And 0. Okay, so we know the horizontal position of the particle at t is equal to 5. We know the vertical position of the particle at t is equal to 5. I know the answer is always 0, seems so unrewarding. But make sure that you, if this is a free response question, that you state your answer in context of the problem with that specific time period. So the position vector of the particle when t is equal to 5 is 43 and 1/3. And 0. I'm Mr. Tarrou. Bam! Go to your homework.